If you need to quickly clean up a file and perhaps remove unnecessary rows, so in this example, all these things here are unnecessary, we don't want them. All we are interested in are these bits of data. You could, I suppose, go and manually go through and delete and keep going. But a better way to do this is highlight the data. Now, quite important, don't let Excel guess. Go all the way to the bottom, highlight it all, go to data, and switch the filter on. And what you can now do is work through the filter and decide what you don't want to see. So in this case, I know that I just want to see this, and I know the data quite well. So when I come here, I know that in this case, because I'm going to try to get rid of it, I want to see what I want to get rid of. So coming down here, I want to see all of that must go. If I remember right, this contains the data I want, so I'm going to deselect it. Okay, so it looks like I've highlighted everything I don't want. When I say okay, it's always a good idea just to scroll down and make sure none of the data that's left behind is a problem for you. You'll see there are some numbers here, but these are the subtotals which I can create on my own. The nice thing about the filter is that if I highlight the row and I go all the way to the bottom up to there, when I delete the row, so I right click over here and I say delete row, Excel is clever enough to realize that I don't want to delete the hidden rows. It's only the visible rows. So I'm going to right click, delete row. And when I clear my filter, you can see that almost immediately my data is quite clean. Now I can see that there's something here that I don't really want. These are maximums and minimums. So I can do another step. In this case, I'm going to say I only want to see the rows that have max and min in that column. Again, we see them all. I highlight the rows, I right click, I say delete row. And when I say clear, suddenly in two steps, I've cleaned up quite a messy report.